In this video, I explain twin pressure valve in a detail. So here you see the three different diagrams for the twin pressure valve. A twin pressure valve is shown in a figure. So here you see the twin pressure valves. Okay. This figure is given for the input A is present and no output at the C. Okay. So what is the A, B, C that we discussed first? It has a two inlet port. One inlet port is A, another inlet port is B, and one outlet port C. So in a twin pressure valve, total three port is there. One port is A port and it is the inlet port. This is the B port, it is also inlet, and this is the port C, this is the outlet ports. Okay. And here one spool is there. So when we supply the fluid from the port A, or either we supply the fuel from the port B, then what happens? Okay. So here the name is given, that is a twin pressure, means from both the inlet port we supply the fluid at the same pressure, then we achieve the output. Suppose we supply the fluid from only one port, then we are not able to achieve the outputs. Okay, that we discuss in a three different cases later on. So this valve has a AND logic functions. Okay, that is a different logic is there, that is AND logic or a OR logic. So in a last video we studied a shuttle valve. So shuttle valve is the OR logic function types valve. OR logic means either we supply the input from a port or either we supply it from the B port, we get the outputs. Okay, so in a shuttle valve we are able to supply the fluid inlet only on a one port, then we are able to achieve the output. But in a twin pressure valves, we need to supply the fluid from the both the inlet port A and B, then we achieve the output, otherwise we are not able to achieve the output. That's why it is called as the AND logic function. AND logic function statement is when both of input signals are present, then only there will be output signals. Means in a twin pressure valve, it is compulsory to supply the input signals from both the input valve, then we are able to achieve the output signals. So here the first case is given. In the first case, you see that is the input A is present, no output at the C. Means in a first figure here you see arrow is mentioned only on A port, here no arrow is there. Means we only supply the fluid in A port, then what happened? This pool is moving in this right directions and the no input is supplied to the output C. Means A and B both are closed and only C is open, but no fluid is supplied to the C ports. Same way in the second image here you see input B is present, no output at the C. Means fluid is supplied from the B port. In A port, we are not supplying any fluid. So then what happened? This pool is moving in this direction, right, and this closed the B port. Means no fluid is supplied to the C ports. So this valve consists of a spool inside the valve body. When working fluid is supplied from only one inlet port, the spool is closed the outlet. So that thing we already discussed, that is the spool is there. Okay, so when we supplied working fluid from only one inlet port, then spool is closed the outlet. Means this outlet port is closed. Here you see in a two image, in a first image the fluid is supplied in only from the A ports, then the output is closed. And in a second diagram we supplied the fluid from only B port, then also the outlet port is closed. So if working fluid is supplied from both of the inlet port, then only the outlet port is open. So here you see this diagram. In this diagram you see that we supplied the fluid from the A port as well as from the B ports. So here already written, both the input A and B are present and the output at the C is present. So here you see the fluid is supplied it from the both the port, and the fluid enter in A port is passed from these pools and then it is supplied it to the C port, same way here. Okay. So when the pressure is available only on the one side, at that time the valve is closed. That's why its name is given the twin pressure valve. So we need to supply the pressure from both the port, then we are able to achieve it. So AND logic is used in a safety circuit. So various type of the safety circuit the twin pressure valve is used. So I also provide the link of the application of twin pressure valve in a card. Card mean on a top right screen of your mobile or laptop you see the I symbols. Okay. So application of twin pressure valve is provided in a circuit design chapters, and I already make the video on that, and I provide the link in a descriptions. So two hand operations of the press is the practical applications of the twin pressure valve, where the press operator has to engage both of his hands to start or operate the press. Thereby his hands will be protected from the accident as he don't have any third hand left below the punch. Means we need to engage the bone hand of the operators. So operator have no any third hand to put the hand in a machines, and that is the chances of accidents. Okay. So this twin pressure valve is generally used for the safety purpose. So we are able to make the both the hand of the operator busy. Suppose operator is pressed the only switch of the A port, then only fluid is supplied in A sides and output is not there. Okay. So operator is also need to press the B switch, means both the hands are busy and we are able to avoid the accident. Now here you see that is the truth table for a twin pressure valve, means we return the signals of the input A and input B. Input A means related to the A port, input B is for the B port, and output port C is there. Means here ESES is written, means we supplied the fluid at the A port. Here ES mentioned in a B means we supplied the fluid in a B port. Okay. Then we achieve output or not? Yes, we are achieving the output if we supplied the fluid from both A and B port. Second case, input in a A port is yes, input in a B port is no. Means here they discuss about the first image. Okay. So here you see input is supplying A port. In a B port we are not supplying the input. And what happened? Output is not achieved. That's why here mention no. In a third case, input A have no input. So here you see no fluid is supplied in A port. But in a B port input is there. So in a input B yes is mentioned. Then what is the output? Output is no, means we are not achieving the output in a C ports. And the fourth one case, that is a no input in both the ports, then by default that is a no output is that. Okay, so here I end this theory. So thank you for watching this video. If you learn something, then like the video and subscribe my channels for watching the more video related to OHP and other subject of the mechanical engineering. For OHP various link is provided in descriptions as well as in a card, and for other subject I request to visit the playlist.